the KTM 450 SXF, all new chassis this year. We got a glimpse of it and what's available for tuning with the factory edition last year. The KTM chassis is amazing. It's really good. If there was a little bit less engine friction feel or a little bit freer revving map, that bike could very easily be first place for me. But yeah, I like it quite a bit though. It's a big improvement over any other KTM I've ever ridden, 450 wise.
It's so crazy the difference between the other Austrian brands and the KTM. The KTM comes ready to race. Although it does have the air fork on there, I mean, that's a simple fix. You know, there's you know, race tech, KYB conversion kits, stuff like that, which, I mean, you have to spend some money. But dude, if you do get that on this motorcycle, it could be one of the best motorcycles you've ever ridden, to be honest. I mean, it's number two for me. Just the only reason it's not number one, it's because of the air fork and a little bit of vibration in the hands on the Austrian bikes. But dude, everything else, the bike is stable. It's freaking ready to race. The thing, it has adjustability, tunability. The aggressive map, it's exciting. It's a very, very stable, sturdy, firm motorcycle. And yeah, I mean, it was number two for me today, but yeah, it's the only reason it was just because of the air fork.
I feel like the new chassis update, I agree with it a lot more than I did when the first generation update that came out. I feel like whatever they changed this year, bracing, adding material, it seemed to help the bike a lot. Like, no longer do I have that chatter coming out of braking bumps. I feel like you go into a corner, I had better lean in, and it was just more comfortable to ride all the way around. The motor's always great on the KTM. It rips, it's got good low to mid, good over rev, so I've never had an issue with that. I love the fact that it has the two map switches. The track gets really beat up, you can, you know, put it in a slower map and seems to do just well. So yeah, KTM did a great job. Great bike.
And honestly, if you ask a lot of these guys, the KTM is probably the best motorcycle. It is geared toward a racer for sure. It is definitely a racing machine. And if you're just cruising around the track, you get a lot of feedback, like through your handlebars. But when you start pushing, that's when the bike starts responding better for sure. So the KTM is definitely a race bike, that's for sure.
So I got a little taste of the 2025 KTM a little earlier when I rode the factory edition bike. Of course, the factory edition has a few bells and whistles that the stock bike doesn't have, but the important stuff, the new chassis, all the work that KTM has done to make that bike more compliant and more comfortable, all translates to the 2025 stock bike. They did a great job on this bike. This is absolutely the best KTM I've ever ridden. The motor is solid. It's not my favorite power delivery. KTM aims at a long, broad, smooth power delivery down low. I would prefer a little bit more excitement. However, they do it with a lot of torque. And so the KTM is one of the few bikes that'll really pull third gear consistently, especially if you carry your speed through the corners. Mid-range is a monster. Top end is unbelievable. I think the suspension is solid. You know, the air fork doesn't offer the plushest feel, but this bike is, it's good. The balance of the bike is solid, and the KTM, in comparison to the other Austrian bikes, is just like their moniker, it's ready to race. So this thing wants to be pushed hard. It rewards aggressive riding styles. You know, if you ride a little bit slower on it, you're cruising, it's not as comfortable. This thing wants to be ridden hard, and it rewards you for it. And for those reasons, I love the new KTM, really pumped on it. If I could change a couple things, it'd be a little bit more snap down low, maybe a little bit more plushness with that air fork. But overall, man, the KTM is a solid package. In fact, one of the most solid packages all around when you consider good cornering, good stability, great engine, man, just confidence inspiring, fit and finish, the Brembo brakes, the clutch. I mean, the thing's awesome. Definitely one of the most popular bikes on the track, and it's evident on how it's achieved that.